Okay, guys. So now last time we hung out, we built out this product page template, and on the front end, it's got all the things that we want, right? We've got our breadcrumbs in here. We've got that vertical gallery. We've got already some of the advanced color swatches or advanced variation swatches, but we can see here on this specific product that I'm looking at that the size is still just this normal drop down, but we're going to fix that now by showing you how to get through those things and show you in more detail. Well, not more detail, but just show you in a better way, a more appealing way, how to display these as beautiful swatches. So, and if we just scroll down, we can see all the other fun stuff that we did. And let's get into it. So we're going to hop here on the back end of our Divi site, of course. And what we need to do to get these sizes to show up maybe as like little round circles with the M or whatever in it, we're just going to have to switch things up a little bit. And that's fairly easy to do. We're going to go to dashboard. We'll go to products and then attributes. Now here on the attributes screen, we've got our sizes and we can go ahead and edit those. And here is where the difference comes in. Now, remember with BodyCommerce, it allows you to enrich your attributes a bit more by letting them either be a color. It can be the select dropdown, which we have right now for the sizes. It can be an image or a color, like we have that already with the brand and the color options with our shirts, or it can be a label. So we want to change this to a label, and I'm going to show you why in a second. You can do your sort ordering, custom order, whatever you want. That's going to be up to you. I'm just going to update this real quick, and then I want to show you if anything happens on the front end. So we'll refresh this page, and now you can see that already it has changed to squares, which is much nicer for us, right? But what if I want these to act a little bit differently than the color ones do? Because that's kind of like what we're looking at here, right? So if you wanted it to say something different than large, medium, or small, you can go ahead and, of course, go here to the attributes and go configure the terms to be, you know, LMS or whatever you want it to be. But what we're going to do right now is we're going to go here to the BodyCommerce settings. We're going to go to our variation swatches. And here we, of course, have individual settings. So when it's the label, you can say, okay, well, the width is going to be this or that or the other thing. You can set the border radius, you can set the label color, the label text color, all that fun stuff. So you can give it specific color. I'm going to go here with the active label color. I'm going to make it black and make sure that the opacity goes up all the way. And then for the active label text color, of course, we're going to need to make that white so that it shows on that black background. And we're going to make the border radius circular. So let's just go all the way to the right here. And what else do we want to do? We can say how high we want the label to be, and we can change the font size and all that fun stuff, but I think we're good for now. And, you know, we talked about the color variations before. That's where you would set those things. So I'm just going to go ahead and save this, and let's see what the effect is on the front end here. Okay, that's looking pretty good, but I don't really care for that border being rectangular, and I'm sure you don't either. So let's go ahead and take a look at how we can change that. So we go down here to variation. Yes, it says variation style is going to be square. Well, let's go with circular. I think that's a little bit better. Now, here is just another thing I didn't show you before, but if you want to enrich those colors even more, we can switch the tooltips to yes. And what that's going to do, I just want to show you real quick before we continue here, is when I refresh and I come and I hover, you can see that it actually tells you what the color is. Now, we would need to go change the active swatch background color here to make sure that that doesn't happen over there, but gives you a nice effect of just telling you what the color is. So if you've got like really fancy names for your different colors, like sandalwood brown or whatever, you can go ahead and get all fancy like that for your visitors. But let's come back here and let me take a quick look at, let's fix that background. You're back on our variation swatch settings. We can for now, and I think this little issue here where we had that black background on the colors is maybe a bug. So let's set this border radius to 500. I've actually also confirmed that if it is a bug, it will be fixed by the time you see this. So don't worry about that too much. All right, so we're going to go further down a bit, and now we want the appearance for the active style also to have a border when it's active. So we're going to give it a border color of black. We're just enhancing this whole setup a little bit. And then border inside color, we're not going to worry about that too much. And then also border width, you can make it, you know, as wide as you want it to be. Cool. And then another thing here on the variation tooltips, which is a fun thing, is that you can make a bigger color or image appear above the item that you're hovering. So let's go ahead and activate that I'm not going to mess with the other settings. But as you can see, there's quite a few options for you here. I'm going to save that. And let's come back here and let's refresh and see what this looks like. Okay. So yeah, there's definitely a little bit of bugginess here going on with the border or this background color, which is a bug, but it will be fixed. I have already reported it. It'll be sorted out. But you get the gist here of what you're able to do. And when you hover the colors, you can see that it makes a nice big version of that. Now, if it was, let's say, a logo or something like that, you could see the full logo. Or if it was, let's say, a material, it'll be a bigger image of that material. So that's a very handy feature to have. It's not very pretty right now, but it will be fixed. That is a bug indeed, but you probably won't even get to experience this bug. And this is how it goes when we do these videos. We just did an update, so tiny little bug slipped through, but that's okay. So that's going to be these variation swatches for you. You've now seen how you can take it from just being a simple drop down to a color, let's say. And then, of course, we do the images also. So that's a very good way to engage your users and do other things to just make your site a little bit more differentiated from the others out there. And let's say you had the different color purses, for example. I just want to mention this too. So maybe you can have the image swatch, but then you just have the different colors of the purses there. And then you use that larger view for the tooltip to show. And now you can, of course, control the size of that tooltip. Let's come down here and we can just go crazy and make it 100 by 100. And let's make the background color not that awful color that we've got going on there. Let's just give it like a light grayish color background and go ahead and save it. And then when we refresh over here, when we hover, you can see now that it's much larger and that we've changed that background color. So there's a lot of different things that you can do here to enhance it. Of course, we've got these little blotches over there, which is the bug I just told you about. But let's not harp on that. So guys, that's going to be it for enhancing your variation tooltip swatches on your single product pages. Of course, you know, we already implemented this in the loop layout that we built earlier when we were dealing with the filters. So this is just another great thing to go ahead and do. And next comes a big and fun feature, which is going to be the compare products table, which is a very dynamic way to show customers how the product that they're looking at compares to other variations or other products in the same category and all that fun stuff. So we're going to get to that in the next lesson real soon. So bye for now.